rabbit's foot, four-leaf clovers. If you use these, even if your car flips over, you'll be fine. Why do people believe in these things? One possibility is that it's a mindset called post hoc fallacy. Post hoc fallacy is like this. Since event B followed event A, event B must have been caused by event A. For example, suppose we won $12 in the lottery today. Well, that's because this morning we visited the temple. Or maybe we just won a sports match. That's definitely because of our lucky shirt. Whatever happened before something else must be linked. What's really interesting is that humans aren't the only ones whose brains work like this.
Animals do it too?
Yep. We can even prove this through an experiment.
Ooh, I like experiments. Tell me more.
The first person who demonstrated this phenomenon was one of the forefathers of behavioral science. His name was B.F. Skinner. If you want to teach a dog a new trick, like give a paw or do my taxes, when it performs the desired behavior, you give it a treat. This basic principle explains how both humans and animals do things to get positive outcomes. In a series of experiments, Skinner used pigeons. Instead of rewarding these pigeons with treats when they pushed a button or when they flapped their wings, he gave out treats every 20 seconds for no reason. It turned out that giving out treats like this created some really wacky behavior in pigeons. Some of them started shaking their heads all the time. Some of them started walking around in circles. Some fluttered their wings incessantly. What had happened was that the pigeons were experiencing post hoc fallacy. As soon as each pigeon got its treat, its brain started trying to associate a behavior with the outcome. It's probably thinking something like,
was I fluttering my wings just now? It must be related. I got a treat 20 seconds later. I'll just keep doing it. Looks like I cracked the code. Ooh, another treat.
Now, what's interesting is that if the pigeons were switched to another cage, if they were doing something else while they received their treat, they begin to adopt other superstitious behavior, like picking at the floor or shaking their heads.
That really makes you think, doesn't it? We're actually hardwired by nature to experience post hoc fallacy. We may believe that our job or life is successful as a result of one factor. It could be a mistake. Athletes with pre-game rituals, students with lucky talismans. I guess next time I experience something big, I need to really take a step back and look at the real reasons why.